Hey, how's it going, guys? This is Ecky-Man, and welcome back to The Binding of Isaac. Okay, so once again, we're going to play Isaac, because I'm still trying to get those items I'm missing. There is the seed, in case you want to play along. So again, we're going to be going for Angel Rooms this run, and hopefully we'll do a bit better than we did last run, because that was just terrible luck. Didn't get a single one, which was kind of surprising, really. I thought we'd at least get one. Okay. Can't go to the shop. Let's do this double room. And hopefully we get some better starting items than we did last time. Alright, well, I'll take Pisces. Let's tears up and I'll knock back shots. Oh yeah, we also will be donating to the shop on this run again, because that's another thing I need to get done. Half heart's no good. Although I could play that sacrifice room and get myself a chest, but I'm just not going to bother with that now. No tinted rocks yet, unfortunately. Telepills. Thank goodness that didn't take me to the Eye Mirror room. And there's a tinted rock. Thank you very much, game. Okay, drop that there. Sigh. Okay, that's fine. And we have one in here anyway, so I'm going to drop that right there. Nice. Should have waited to pick that up. So now I really need to not get hit at all. Alright, sell down. There we go. Health up. Yeah, okay. Lock up two keys. Didn't really need that. I'm gonna go and open that chest as well. Goat head. That is what I wanted to see. Yes. Okay, first floor goat head. That's brilliant. So, now we just need to turn down our first deal with the devil, and hopefully we're going to have a bit more luck with getting angel rooms here. Which is awesome. That is better than I really could have hoped for. First floor goat head is always really nice to get. Especially more so when I'm particularly aiming to try and get... Alright, I'm going to take damage here, so it's fine. Wasn't even going to try and dodge that. Wasn't happening. There we go. And here's our boss. Well, I need to fight one more room before I fight the boss, so... Go and do that now. So now it doesn't really matter if I have soul hearts or not, although obviously it'd be nice to have them, but we are guaranteed our devil and angel rooms on every floor it's possible to earn them on. Okay, let's go fight the boss. Obviously, we're going to get a devil room for this first room where we can earn them. Again, hopefully it's Krampus. Knockback's pretty nice for this boss. Means I can really keep them away from me. Alright, at some point, you guys will explode. Not on me. Yeah, I really don't want that. Oh, another one with a badden in. That's what I got in the last, the first ever room. That's a shame. I'd love to take it, but I can't. I'll reroll you. Yeah, okay, evil up 3 bonds. I'll take that. Probably should have just gone with what I had, but eh. See if we can get another reroll before the item run, but I very much doubt it. Still gotta find the shop as well. I'm totally doing this. And swallowed penny, so that's gonna give me a chance of dropping money when. Ever I take damage. Money that wasn't mine as well, so that's profit. Which is good, given that I need to upgrade the shop. And there we go. First bit of cash dropped. I'm going to go to the curse room. That's happening. Alright, nice. Okay, so we're going to get 1/3 of the way to being Guppy here. Guppy's head spawns 2 to 5 kamikaze flies to do 2 times my damage. Now I would consider re-rolling in there. Assuming the shop has a battery anyway. Okay, yep, well that's happening. Holy mantle. That's going to enable me to take 1 free hit. Alright, no battery. It's fine. Okay, just give all my money to the donation machine here. And I have a coin I can pick up right there, so I will do it. Shame I don't have a reroll for Guppy's head. Could potentially get another Devil Room item out of that, but everything should work out, so I'm not worried. I'll blow these up though, just in case we get more money. Which we don't. They can drop a quarter as well, which would have been nice there. Challenge room. Nah, not too interested in that. Could have been good though, I mean, it could have something awesome in that chest, like a cricket's head or something. Chances are it wouldn't though. Alright guys, calm down. I need a damage up. Right, we will kill you eventually. There we go. Yes, I'll bomb for that. That's money I can donate to the shop. I'll buy a battery with or something, because remember, angel rooms and devil rooms are going to stay open now, even after I leave them. So there is potential for us to get another reroll or a battery and then reroll in an angel room again. Is that Capricorn? Yeah, that's an all stats up. Okay, that's pretty nice. So there's my damage up. Although I think it's only like 0.3 damage up, but still, it's a fire rate up, a speed up, a range up, health up, all the good stuff. Alright, so we're gonna have to go and do the quad room, and then hopefully we'll get an angel room here. I really hope we do. Seeing as the game was so stingy with them on the last run. There goes my free hit for the room. If I had a Sin Heart in here, I would totally just take damage on purpose. That's interesting. Paperclip. So, golden chests will all be completely free now. Right, that yellowy champion can drop a battery, so that would be nice if he could do. Right, not going to happen though. They're not going to gather around there. That's fine. Blow it up anyway, just in case we got a magic mushroom. So, now I have this trinket. I'm probably going to go and do the challenge room. Let's see what that chest had. Oh, this is going to take forever. Finally, okay. And there's the boss. Okay, Angel Room. I'll check that pill when I'm done with the floor as well, by the way. I don't want it to be a telepills and end up in the I Am Error Room. My free hit. Well, that's cool. We're not going to lose our Devil Room chance. Angel Room! Yay! And I get a speed up. Alright, so we get. Is it Breath of Life? I've already picked that up before, though, so. I'm not going to do that. So this might take a while to do. But. We are going to get two rerolls for this, or two items to reroll, I should say. How did that not hit me? Still haven't lost my free. Oh no, there. I've lost my free hit now. Yeah, damage is pretty bad right now. Is the one problem with fighting the angel this early. But we'll get there. Yeah, it's going to cost me some health to do though. I'm actually going to blow up a few of these. I was kind of hoping for the soul heart there, obviously. Do this one as well. Nothing. Really? Okay. Alright, I am eventually gonna kill you. There's no point resisting here. It's happening. Trust that it will happen. He's going to give me a key piece. There we go. And I can reroll both of these now. Alright, well that's pretty good actually. The wafer means that all damage that would normally be a full heart is only a half heart. And we get the Trinity Shield, which shields me from incoming tears in whichever direction I'm holding it in. That's pretty good. So we got a look up. I haven't found the shop yet, so let's go and find that. So Trinity Shield and Holy Mantle basically means we're virtually untouchable. Yeah, I'm just going to donate all my money here. Actually, I will buy the Soul Heart. Okay, so let's just leave the floor then, I guess. Yeah, nothing else I can do in there. Probably should have done a full clear. There was always a chance of a curse room giving us something good. And I meant to go back and do that golden chest. Oh well, never mind. It's fine. Does this shield me from explosions as well? Apparently it does. Ah, I wasn't holding it the right direction there. Alright, let's see what you are. Suicide King. Okay, well, if I get a respawn... again, I... It would be the second guppy item. I'll take it. And I want to check what that rune is as well, but... Well, I'm definitely taking that. That's a damage up. This one's shaping up to be better than the last one. So yeah, if I get something like 9 lives, a dead cat even, or just anything that gives me a respawn ability, I can use Suicide King. And that will drop a bunch of items, chests, and potentially some podium items as well, so could be good. And if we do it in a curse room, then we should get devil or angel room items for that. I can see forever. Opens up all the secret runes. It's useful. So Guppy's Collar anyway is 50% chance to respawn in the room I die in. Puts me 1/3 of the way to being Guppy as well, so it's a decent item, just not entirely what I was hoping for. No point going to the shop, I have no money. Okay, boss room. Speed down. That's kind of a pain. Alright, well, I'm going to get a guaranteed devil room item here. Shield helps so much in this fight, but it's not going to block lasers though, so I'm not even going to try that. Spirit of the Night gives me flight and spectral tears, and yeah, I don't want that. Is there anything else I really want from this floor? I mean, I can try for money, I guess. Goat Hoof, that trinket that I haven't picked up would give me a slight... I think it's a 10% speed increase. Two of Hearts, no point. I really hope I don't use this Suicide King by mistake. Get away from me. Damage still doesn't feel where it should be, but I know that we have had a few damage ups. Oh yes, of course, I should be checking for secret rooms, because one of the items I need is in there as well. But not that. I didn't want to... Nope. Whatever. Didn't want to give him any money. I wanted to donate that in the shop. Okay, go in the boss challenge room. Okay. Right. Found both the secret rooms, yeah. Oh, I can check what you are now. Passage, alright. How about a black market? Nope. Okay, I'm just gonna leave the floor now then. Yeah, I'll do this. Kind of worth it. So it would have been nice for just a straight teleport to the angel or devil room. I could have best used my D6, or made the best use of my D6. Okay. I should probably just bomb to get out of here, but I won't be lazy, I will do it. Wish I had more bombs for all these skulls. Do that one. If my bumper will work. There we go. Purity. Yeah, it's useful, but not right now. But purity would remove the curse from the current floor. But we don't have one, so... Definitely going in here because it's free. Right, have the boss to the item room, please, because I'm wasting D6 charges here. Big time. Item room, thank you. Does this block chubbies? No, it doesn't. Okay. Well, good to know. I kind of wish the shield did though. It blocks tears, it should block them. I guess it makes sense. It doesn't block lasers either, so why would it block those? Notched axe, that's terrible. What are we on? Necropolis 1. I'm rerolling you and getting myself Sad Onion, which is a tears up, and I'm fine with that. Shop, nice, I can donate all this money to it. And that. Although I would love to buy mom's key, but no. Actually, I'm going to leave 5 cents so I can buy that battery. If I get an angel room here, then I can double back, grab that battery, and re-roll. No. Steady on. There we go. Flight and spectral tears is just so handy. It really is. Bomb for that tinted rock. And some more money I can donate. Nice. Alright, I hope this is the path to the boss, because then it looks like my reroll will time out really well here. I'm gonna save my bomb. As much as I'd like to use it here, I'm gonna save it. Anything? No. Oh, adversary. Well, it's fine. I can take a free hit. Gotta remember to do quarter circles around this guy. Thank you for the free soul heart there, buddy. Yeah, he has like a homing brimstone attack, which apparently he's not in the mood to use right now, which is fine with me. And another free soul heart. Thanks, buddy. Ah, there's his brimstone attack. Angel room. No! Well, at least I got a damage up. I'd love to take it, but I can't. So, I'm going to double back to the shop, donate the rest of this money, and then we're just going to get on with the run. There's nothing else really here for me, I guess. No. Being able to carry 2 trinkets would be mildly useful, but I'm not too worried about it at this point. So let's move on and hope for an angel room on the next floor. There are items that increase your chance of angel rooms, actually. Like, is it the Bible tract, I think? Gives you an increased chance of angel rooms. And if you at least take 1 key piece, I think that that increases your chance of further angel rooms so that you can complete your key set before you get to the Mega Satan fight. And here comes my dog to say hello. Hey, buddy. And he's off again. He's not interested in Isaac. Oh, curse of the maze. So amusing, thank you. The virus, no thanks. And I don't want that either. Let's see if we can get another reroll. Should be able to. Can't go to the boss challenge room, unfortunately, not unless we find a temperance, a blood donation machine or a temperance card. Or hematemesis pill. Okay, I can't kill the white one yet. There we go, now I can. Well, we're definitely in a better position damage-wise than we were in the last run, that's for sure. Double locked room, I'm gonna go to it. And it is a 2, which, let me consult my notepad. Rerolls all the pickups in a room, so let's do that. Wheel of Fortune, the Magician. I'm going to stick with Suicide King just in case we get a chance to use it. Look up, I'm fine with. Okay, let's try and find the boss. And the shop, actually. I need to find the shop, so... try and kill these guys over the gaps. Although, it's not always guaranteed, obviously. And I've just given up on that entirely. Yeah, if you kill them over gaps in the floor, they don't spawn the additional mobs. Isaac's head. Now I wish I'd bought the mom's purse for more trinket room. That is a familiar that fires piercing tears. Compass would be extremely useful, but I'm not going to be... actually, I should go and re-roll the item room now. I'm not going to be able to go back for that battery after the angel room because I would need to be able to teleport out of there, and that's obviously not happening. So I'll reroll the item room, I'll grab the battery, and then we'll push on for the boss. Curse of the maze. Frustrating. Okay, piercing tears. Actually, I already had piercing tears. Oh no, I didn't. No, I had spectral. So that's good. Piercing tears now allow my tears to pass through enemies and damage enemies behind them. It's a good item. Very useful. So I'll grab my battery and be on my way. Keep instinctively trying to dodge incoming tears, but I have absolutely zero need to with the setup I have right now. It's only contact damage that's really a problem. Okay, let's go do the mom fight. I'm just going to do this normally rather than trying to cheese it. If I had a high damage orbital, I would probably try and cheese. And another devil room. Well, I still have one more chance of an angel room, so we'll stick to it. But if I get 9 lives there, then I'll probably just take it and use Suicide King. Because chances of getting a port or a card to go to the angel room on the chest or the cathedral is pretty low, to be honest. I'm really tempted to just bomb my way through some of these rooms until I find what I'm looking for. But if I've got a double back, I'm going to end up fighting them anyway, so... let's just take them down. It's not like we're in danger of losing too much health here. It's going to be the quad room. You know it is. Oops, I thought I was safe there, but apparently not. Let's keep going left. Curse room, definitely going in there as it's free. Judgment, I'll use this now. Yeah, I didn't think Holy Shield worked on that. Lucky Toe, not much good to me. Right, I need a half heart and then I can make use of that better. Oh, that's annoying. Look up. Telepills. Yeah, I want to keep Suicide King, so I can't really use it. Do I have a half red heart? There's a full. There's a half. Excellent. So I'll grab that. Go back and play this beggar some more. The reason I wanted a half heart is because I can take advantage of Polaroid invincibility to play this a few times. Oh, I have the wafer. Of course I do. Well, that's fine then. Rules card. Sleeping gatekeepers will need to be awoken with a loud sound. Mom's bottle of pills. I'll use it once. Speed up. That's good. I'll reroll you. Mr. Boom, I'm not really interested in. And now I need to get myself a reroll. Forgot about that. Still, we should be able to do it. I've got plenty of rooms left. And you can't actually hit me. And I have a battery. I will come back for the battery. I'll pick the half red heart up, though. See if I can get a reroll naturally, and then if not, I'll go back for the battery. Ah, this sucks. I could just bomb out of here actually, but I have piercing tears and spectral, so I can actually do this really easily. It's not quite the chore it usually is. Okay, reroll just in time. And then I can go back and use that battery as well. So, we're really, really hoping on an angel room here. Skolex, that kind of sucks, but it's just pin, basically, just a harder to hit pin. Wire coat hanger, tears up. And what have we got in here? Oh, I can't tell, can I? That sucks. Well, I can't earn any more devil runes, so it doesn't matter if I take these deals, so I'm going to do it. The pact, damage and tears up. Lord of the Pit, demon wings. Well, had I known it was that, I'd have rerolled it. So, we're going to double back and re-roll this item in here. Number one, tears up. Do I keep my range? That stinks. I mean, I already had a fast fire rate anyway, but now that's quite a significant range down. Yeah. Alright, well, let's move on. So, once again, we don't get what we want from angel runes, but I'm going to keep trying. One angel room out of this entire run, though, it's very stingy, in my opinion. Yeah, I'll take infestation too. So now every time an enemy dies, it will spawn a friendly spider that does 2.5 times my damage. It's a great item. Got a crazy fast fire rate now. That's something to reroll. Wow, Right, this guy's gonna give me a lot of spiders when he dies. Segmented enemies generally give you quite a lot. Golden keys, so unlimited keys for the floor. Not that that really matters, as soon as I have paperclip. Yeah, sure thing, I'll play you. If I get a teleport to the devil room or an angel room now, I'm gonna be annoyed. Play you a few times, because it's only gonna cost me half a soul heart, and I can take advantage of Polaroid invulnerability. Speedball, I don't really want that. Nah, I don't want Child's Heart either. Alright, so I have two things I can potentially reroll here. I'm just gonna blow you up. I'd rather reroll in the challenge room though. So let's go and do that now. Quad shots. I will take it because I have such a high fire rate already. So I may as well do. Range sucks really bad though, still. Quad shot with this fire rate is pretty nice. I'm gonna try. What a waste of a key. I'm gonna try and get another. Oh no, I've got golden keys, so it doesn't matter. I'm gonna try and get another reroll before we go and fight the boss. Just so I can reroll speedball into something useful, maybe. Thankfully, it's going to be very easy to do. Ah, okay, I'll reroll you. Soy milk. No, I do not want soy milk. I suppose it could be kind of fun with quad shot, but... Now I'm tempted to take it. I'll be honest. Look up. How much luck have we got? Quite a bit, actually. It'd be nice to find something like Tooth Shot. Okay. Two more rooms. And I may still end up taking soy milk. Kind of hoping this is a five dice room. Oh no, okay. Well, this is good anyway. I can see forever. And there goes my dog. Sorry about that, guys. All the secret rooms now open. I'm going to have to go and fight the boss before I get a reroll, so let's go and do that. Speedball, what did I have in here? Oh, it's just a trinket. Alright, well, spiders should wreck this. If they actually start putting some work in, anyway. Okay, so we're gonna go and re-roll in the boss challenge room. Oh no, I already did that. Okay, well, I'll reroll speedball. I can see forever. I've seen everything. X-ray vision. So that opens up all the secret rooms anyway. You know what? Okay, let's do it. Let's just take... As stupid an idea as this is, Let's do it. Let's take soy milk. It's a damage down, but tier's way up. I want to try and find the top secret room before I leave. And there it is. So I just... yeah, I don't really want that. I have terrible range. And probably terrible damage now. But super fast quad shot. Which is fun in a way. No, I want to keep that. Okay, let's do this. It's this kind of a setup I really want for a lost run. Well, not the quad shot soy milk. Actually, yeah, our damage is pretty good. Surprisingly. The Trinity Shield and Holy Mantle would just be perfect for a lost run. Why am I trying to avoid tears? I don't need to avoid them. To worry about his attacks at all. Let's just try and melt him. Alright, we've got him on this cycle. And off we go to the chest. So, all these chests are free for us. Blank card. If I had 9 lives right now... that would just be awesome, because I could use Blank Card Suicide King over and over again. As it is, I'm going to save it till the end of the run. Ipecac. That could potentially just be suicide. Let's do it. This is not going to end well, but whatever. Kind of think the old setup was better, but whatever. Reroll all of you. Sure thing, I'll take speed and a range up. And charm tears as well. Well, it's not ever... it's not often, if ever, I would take this combination, so this is kind of fun, I guess. Yeah, Aquarius, it's a terrible item, I'm just going to pick it up. Leaves a trail of tears behind me as I go, which will damage enemies if they walk over it. Oh, Joker. Well, I guess it could technically be an angel room. I'm sure even after I take a deal with the devil, I should still have a 50% chance of getting it. I think. Well, we'll soon find out anyway. Maybe we'll get 9 lives. So I'm going to take this health up. And then go and do that. Oh, Krampus. Yeah, I'll take Sister Maggie. I was really hoping for 9 lives there, but... oh well. Well, actually, an angel room with the items I needed would have been better, but whatever. Poison tears, I will take it. Hippocack already adds a poison element, so it's not as useful as you would think. Why are you getting a lot of chests considering I haven't had Guppy's tail? Yeah, it's definitely fun to have Ipecac every once in a while. Even nicer with Pyromaniac, but... I'll re-roll here. Yeah, I'm not too interested in that. Piggy bank. We are really getting a lot of chests here. Judgment. I'll use you. Blow you up. Get an extra item. Should have done that in another room. And then I could have re-rolled it. Oh well. And you know what? I may as well just pick this up as well. So that was Charm of the Vampire, which would make kills, heal me for red hearts. Wow, this is just so noisy because of the explosions. But obviously, it's really not much good to me. I will take Rainbow Baby. Alright, two more rooms and I can reroll. Yeah, I'll do it. You never know, we might get Curved Horn. Or Cancer, which would make this even crazier. Vision gives me the whole map. Yeah, not interested in that. Yeah, you know what? I'm just gonna blow you up. Monstro's Tooth, not interested. Is that Mr. Boom? Mr. Mega, even. So let's increase blast damage. And five extra bombs. Oh, scythes! Does this. Ah, little miniature explosive scythes. Does it get any better than that? I'll take Daddy Longlegs, I suppose I might as well pick up Best Bird. And what? So what did we leave behind in the initial item room? Let's go and just check what we have available to us. I don't want Kamikaze. That's Mr. Boom. I suppose I'll take Midas Touch for all the good that's going to do me. Alright, let's go fight the boss. And then try Suicide King out. Actually, nah, I suppose there's not really any point after we've fought the boss, so I'm just gonna leave it. Okay. Well, we're gonna keep trying for these angel rooms, and donating to the shop. But yeah, that's gonna do me for today, guys. So as always, I really hope you've enjoyed watching this. I'm out for now, and I will see you soon for some more of The Binding of Isaac. Peace.